Don't forget to check us out on Patreon, where you'll receive exclusive content to videos that are not available on YouTube. And for those of you that like the one video instead of the two video format, you get that as well.
Bam.
For a dollar.
Bam.
It's a dollar a month.
Yep. I think we're cooler than a bag of Cheetos.
You can't even get that for a dollar.
Hey, that's true. Not hot Cheetos, though. Only like regular Cheetos.
So check us out on Patreon, guys. We hope to see you there. Bless this immunity. Bless this immunity. Now I'm just joking.
Black people always gotta add beats in the shit, huh?
We always gotta hip hop shit out, man. Yeah, I'm just messing around, man. That fear inoculum, though, dude, that shit was hard.
Yeah, man.
It was hella hard.
Actually better the more we listened to it as well. Like, all that did was improve over every listen. So that was a great song. Tool fans have been going so crazy.
On
all of our platforms. They're like, fuck that. I don't want the usual one song here and there. Y'all need to do the whole album. So the demand has been pretty high for this Tool album. The buzz has been amazing. And based off of what I've been seeing just online and throughout the comments, man, it just seems like this album has been living up to
the high
expectations, man.
Exceeding expectations,
yeah,
I think.
Yeah, seriously.
Which is crazy because Tool is already great, you know? And
so we knew we had to, like, we were like, okay, let's get back to the album. Let's do something else. The Tool fans have been just getting at us. And not even just, I would say, even standard Tool fans, just people who are just fans of music have been really clamoring for another review off the album. So here we are. We're doing Numa. And Numa means the vital spirit, soul, or creative force of a person. We had to look that shit up.
Yeah, I'm telling you.
I think we have to always do that with Tool. Like, what the fuck does that mean?
I'm telling you, man.
So
Tool really gives you a different perspective, man. They have their own sound. Obviously, everybody knows that, man. But I love the fact that we have to look shit up, though. We have to really take you on this journey in their music. And even just the titles, like George said, we had to look it up and really just kind of do some kind of research to know what the song's going to be about. I think that's dope, man.
Which direction they're taking you, yep.
Yeah, I really can't say that about a lot of artists, man, in any genre.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? You pretty much know by the title, you know, what it should be about, you know, type of thing. But
I wanted to get some incense, you know what I'm saying, some sage or some shit. I don't know, fucking some sage, light the sage up, get the bad spirits away. I wanted to be a little bit more prepared for this listening experience. But let's get into it, man. We don't want to talk your head off.
Let's do it, dude.
This is the second song, right, off of Fear Inoculum. We obviously did Fear Inoculum. Check that reaction out if you haven't seen it.
Yep, and this is the second song.
This is the second song on the album.
Yeah.
So Fear Inoculum was the first song. So maybe that's the reason why you guys went so hard for this one. Maybe it makes sense in terms of how it transitioned.
Flows or whatever.
How it flowed into this song.
Yep.
Let's see. Y'all been requesting it. Y'all been on our ass.
Let's go.
Let's get into it. Tool, Numa, We Believe. Those riffs already remind me of something. Spaghetti, knees weak, arms are heavy.
No.
I want to say it so bad. All right, I want to say it so bad. All right. This vomit on the shirt already. Mom's spaghetti. That would be funny, though. They'd be like, fuck you.
Thank you.
the same
that
time.
Hard. Yeah,
did y'all catch that? Y'all catch that, like, that grunt that we both laid out at the same time?
You know,
Before you get into it, that grunt, I hope they caught that on camera. We was like,
yeah, we had the same reaction at the same time.
With that drumming. Damn.
God.
Go ahead, Russ.
I'm just going to basically talk about why we did that. Yeah. It's like, you know, you hear the odd time signature within that that groove right there, but the way the drumming that man, that shit is fire. You know what, man? I'm gonna wait. You know, I'm not gonna be like the Tool super fan that some people are. I'm not gonna go off the bandwagon and be like, man, they just off the chain. But I always get excited to hear their music, man. I'm always like, man, you know what, man? They really are the truth.
They give you a feeling. They just give you a different type of feeling, right? Like,
yeah,
unlike
man.
Anything you've ever heard, which is why it's exciting. You know what I mean? Which is why I really enjoy Fear Inoculum, because it's like, I know some Tool fans are like, well, it's just kind of like a lot of what they've done before. But it's like, I'm not like extremely, like you said, I'm not a super fan of the band. So I'm not listening to Tool 99% of the time like a lot of the fans do. So for me, someone that's not, like, you know, overindulging in the music,
right,
it's always gonna sound fresh, right? I mean, I still listen to them from time to time, but for me, it was like a breath of fresh air amidst the mediocrity. You know what I mean? Because regardless of what you want to say, they did that shit at a high level. They do is what they do, and it's at a high level. So for someone who's not constantly listening to their music, that was a great, great experience. So, but this one's sounding pretty promising.
Yeah, already.
Let's keep it going.
That's the way that transition into that time signature is crazy. There is no joke.
Already, like 2 minutes in this bitch. This shit is looking crazy.
This is wild.
Reach out and beyond this flesh.
Sound. You gonna come to us. That's what you say all the time, right?
Yeah.
Bring the people to you. Fuck chasing the sound. Bring
you
it to you.
To
okay, Tool. That's what you're doing. That was nasty though.
Is this like a spiritual awakening? I feel like I'm having. I think it's this song about a spiritual awakening of sorts.
My God.
That's what I feel like I'm having, man.
Yeah,
Jesus
I'm telling you.
Christ. I feel like Bruce Leroy. I feel like Bruce Leroy in The Last Dragon when he finally got his shit. He got that glow.
Yeah, you are the
I feel like the
last
fucking glow is
dragon.
Around me right now. Yeah. I don't know if Tool fans fuck with The Last Dragon. But regardless,
man.
The drumming in this, is just already.
Did you see the way that they rocked transition. You into that transition? Yeah. The way that that came in?
I was bugging before that. Yeah. I was bugging out over the drumming and that. Apparently, he was just getting started.
Oh, my God.
But that long, hard, it was like being on a roller coaster and then that drop, right? Mm-hmm. It's like being on a roller coaster and they drop you in with that crazy bottom, bottom, yep. bottom.
That was... You know, that's my shit, guys. Yeah. I love those long, powerful riffs, man. I love that. And I love that their sound, though. It's like even Fear Inoculum, when the way the guitar sounded in that was like tuned differently or something like that.
Yeah.
They have such unique sounds within the music, man. So dope, man. Dope. I love that. We got to definitely run that back.
Yeah, that was amazing. Yeah. We're going to run that back. But I think one of the things that I think has happened to us, or at least one of the genres that has really sort of had an effect on us is like prog rock.
Yes.
And what we've loved about prog rock is the atmosphere that's created.
Yes.
You know what I mean? And some of the other, a lot of the sort of the nuances, right? The details, all of these little elements that they're adding in to create such a unique atmosphere it's just cool, man. It's really, really.
And it's them.
It really is them.
It's them. That's what I love about it, man. It's like, because I know I was bugging out there a minute ago, but the bottom line is, man, the sound comes to them. Yes. Right? I mean, not the sound, but the fan base comes to them because of their sound.
Innovators.
You know what I mean? That's innovators. Dope, man. You know what I mean?
No, I get it. Talk your shit, Tool fans, all right?
There really are truth, man.
There's a lot of y'all out there that's a little overzealous, but talk your shit, man.
But it's justified, though. Yeah. It's justified. Right. They are dope, man.
Yeah, yeah, they are fire, though. But you can talk your shit.
Yeah.
Let's keep it going. That was amazing how that transition, how it dropped into those heavy riffs. That was pretty cool.
I don't know if we're gonna get through this song, man.
Once you down about you, reach out beyond.
It's just that bass is always. This is incredible. I don't need to hear the rest of the song.
Yeah, this is incredible.
It's over. We're 3 minutes and 56 seconds in. Jesus Christ.
Yeah, they're losing their mind.
Speaking of Jesus, I'm ready to drink the Jesus juice. Yeah. I want to put on a white linen robe, and I want to fucking hold hands in a circle, and I want to drink Jesus juice.
Man, this is crazy.
I want my spirit to be taken. We are bound to the flesh. What did he say? Bound to reach out beyond this flesh. Yeah, I'm drinking my Jesus juice, too. That's it.
That's dope.
I don't know what else to say.
Keep it rocking.
The bass line, obviously, that's a signature of Tool, right? Having sort of an incredible bass line that puts you, like you had mentioned before, it kind of puts you into this trance, right?
One of the things that I keep going back to, George, and we keep bugging out on in this video, man, is the way, you know, you hear that odd time signature type of style that they have, right? But the drumming almost immediately after the time signature change there, that dun, 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 bum, bum, you know what I mean? It's almost like the drumming hides the fact that it's an odd time signature.
Yes.
It makes it so smooth.
It's smooth as hell.
You know? And you're like, wait, I hear the odd time signature, but I don't, because the drumming is complementing it so well that it's just so smooth.
Yeah.
And I, you know...
I don't know
if I've heard that before, I don't know if I've heard it like that before.
We every time they do that, they've done that, what, 3 or 4 times throughout the song? Well, they've done it. We're like, every time. Nasty. It's like we haven't heard this shit before. We just heard it, and every time they do it, there's something in that that really seems to grab us. And the emphasis that he's, there's an extra emphasis with his voice, right? We are that really adds during to that as time. Well during yep. that during that phase yep. during that section as well exactly. during that part as well. So,
and I love that.
This is just fire to me. This is great. Seriously, let's keep it going.
Yeah, man.
It's been a while since we've really.
We ain't gonna get through this, man.
It's been a while since we heard one like this, bro.
Yeah, this is.
This is not a comprehensive breakdown or review. This is just a reaction. My gut is telling me this is one of the best Tool songs that I've personally heard. I have not heard their entire discography, but this to me sounds like an upper echelon Tool song to me, based off of what I'm hearing, the intricacy.
Yeah, man.
I even love the melody, the "We Are," how he's singing that, right? I love the emphasis that his voice is how his voice is sort of making a marriage, right? Yep. With the drumming as well, and the drumming and the bass,
yep,
and the sort of the guitar work,
the nuances,
I mean, I'm just putting it all together, and it's great, man. Let's keep it going.
You know what, man? They're just the truth, man. This is really incredible, man. I know we sound like a broken record, but they really are the truth, man. And I feel like, George, man, you
I'm
ever
going to make fun of someone who doesn't like this song. I'm judging you. I'm joking, but not really. Off camera.
Man, you know how like
it's a great song, dude.
In life, man, you run into people that are like super fans on various different things, man. You ever notice that?
Yes.
Like some people like are super LeBron fans or super Michael Jordan fans or super
to an unhealthy level.
Right. And you know, it's just you almost get to the point in your life, especially as a grown man, you're like, yeah, they're dope, man. But damn, man, you know, there's other dope people, too.
And they're not going to help me move. If I need a couch move, I can't call fucking LeBron James to help me move my couch. It's not like he's my best friend. Like, he doesn't know you, man.
Exactly.
He doesn't know you.
And that's how I feel about Tool fans. Until you hear something that is just so undeniable, just like LeBron bringing people back in the playoffs, Jordan doing phenomenal things in the playoffs, whether you like them, dislike them, or you're just indifferent, certain people in life are so phenomenal, and this band is just one of them that you gotta give it up. Like, this is just incredible.
13 year
layoff. It's incredible, dude.
I agree, dude. A 13 year layoff, and they come back. Yes. And I said before in the last video, in restore order. Oh, y'all done got it all fucked up. Y'all don't know who we are, huh? Okay.
That is so bad. Everybody's drumming. Come on, that ass. They could end the song right there. Nobody can take too much more of this shit, dude. I'm about to lose my voice. It's crazy.
It's going to be. But this could be how many movies could this be placed in?
Yep. This is fire, dude.
See, just these little nuances, it brings it all together, dude.
The bass, man.
Oh, yeah.
This is.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, this is nasty. Oh, yeah. This is an awakening, right? It really is. Once I was blind, but now I can see. You know what I'm saying? Seriously. You know what I mean?
I don't know what to say.
Hey!
This is fire.
This is fire, dude.
The way that makes you feel.
This past. I hope they're jamming this shit like we are. I hope you got this shit loud that you're playing this back. This is dope.
Back into the watch.
George said is kind of like an awakening, and it really is, man. I feel like once I was blind, but now I can see.
It's
the, you know what I'm saying? I see what makes this shit so incredible, man.
During that we had that Rush La Villa Strangiato. Check that video out. We did a video to La Villa Strangiato, and I said, you know, I like Rush. Rush is great. They're clearly great virtuoso musicians. They're great. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And I just always looked at them as great. But I saw like the sort of the intensity that their fans kind of displayed in the comment section about Rush. They were so hardcore Rush fans. Mm-hmm. And I was just like, I mean, I like them. You know what I'm saying? They're cool. But I don't know if I like them like that. But I do appreciate what they can do, and I like their music. Yes. Mm-hmm. And that song, when we listened to that and we really paid attention to the nuance and the intricacies of that song, just the level of skill that it took to pull that off, it gave me that aha moment.
It was an awakening, right?
I was like,
it's an awakening.
Ah, now I'm understanding what people were talking about. Now I see why the Tool Army exists, because these guys are just special, man.
Yeah, dude.
To create this.
Incredible.
This is special. You know what I mean? So we're gonna run that part back.
I'm loving everything about this song, though, George. And that's no bullshit, because there's a lot of songs that we do, and you know, and I know you guys know if you watch the channel, that I'll be like, you know what? I wasn't really rocking the song up until this. Or I like the song in its entirety, but there was a part of the song I wish they would have did this better. I wish they would have did that better. There is nothing about this song that I'm like, they could have did better. This song all the way through is fire. And I don't say that a lot about a lot of long songs.
It's hard
this to song is fucking long.
Crazy. This is reaching one of the best songs we've heard on the channel. Ever. Man. Like, you guys know, we don't react like this over anything.
I'm telling you.
Let's get back to it.
Incredible.
All right, let's get back to it,
man. That was so nasty, though.
Reach out beyond.
incredible, dude.
That was a lot.
That was incredible to me. That was incredible. They killed that. They killed that, dude.
That was excellent. But this was given to me by the great Mario of Gojira, the drummer there. Salute to my man. Every time a drummer loses his fucking mind and makes me go crazy, you get one of these, man. That I want this to be an honor. I'm not going to give this out to everybody, but Danny Carey was phenomenal. Yeah,
incredible.
This entire song.
Incredible.
He was amazing, dude. That was just a great, great, great masterpiece. Masterful performance.
You know,
by these gentlemen, man.
I agree with you, man. I don't really have much to add to that, George. I'm as you were talking, though, man, I was sitting here looking at how many people were involved in making this track. And, dude, it's a damn syllabus. You know what I'm saying? There's so many people that are involved in making just this one track. Just this one track, from the guitar technicians, plural. Drumming technicians, plural. You know what I'm saying? Recording engineers, mixing engineers. I mean, the list is on and on. This one track sounds like, it looks like a damn finishing to a movie. You know how you see the movie and you see the film editor and the this and the producer. You know, it's got that many credits. That's how many people... And like I'm
being
involved
in the process.
But that's how many people were involved in this process to make this song great. And it sounds like it.
It sounds like it.
It sounds like it.
It sounds like they took 13 years off and fucking were so meticulous about every nuance, every nook and cranny within the song, man. And they wanted to make sure that they created a masterpiece.
And
that's what it sounds like. To me, off of first listen, I'm gonna listen again. You know, but this to me sounds like a masterpiece. There's nothing that I dislike about this song. I like the lyrics. I love Maynard and just his voice and how it seems to tap into a different part of you and what the lyrics seem to be saying. You know what I mean? Just sort of, looking beyond the flesh. It seems like it's kind of talking about not being bound by flesh. Mm-hmm. We are sort of the spiritual beings. And like I said, it was like a spiritual awakening.
And you know what, George, man? Not to cut you off there. I cannot wait to re-listen to this song, man, because Fear Inoculum was dope too. And the more times we listen to that shit, it's gotten even better to me. Because
yep,
I like
me
Fear Inoculum as well when we listen to it.
Yeah.
But that's gotten better as I've heard. I can't wait to put this on a playlist to re-listen to it to have a deeper appreciation to this song. This could be one of their crown jewels.
I
know they already have plenty, but I think that this could be one of them,
dude,
in 2019.
So let's look at what we heard. What did we do with reaction? Let me see. We're going to extend the video a little bit, guys. Let me revisit.
So we got 46 and 2.
Real quick.
The pot, right?
46 and 2. Got it. Okay. Got it. Cool.
Yep.
Great song.
Yep.
Great song.
Mm-hmm.
Real quick.
The pot.
Pot was hot.
That was hot, too.
The pot was hot.
Because we like
real
that
quick
a lot, yeah.
Just a little taste, just to jog my memory to a point where, because I'm just trying to figure out.
Who are you to?
This was great.
Yeah, this was hot, though. We gonna get through this, George. We gonna get through it. Yeah, this was hot, dude. Yeah, this is hot, dude.
This is great.
Yeah.
That was great.
Don't make me pick, George. Don't make me pick, please.
I think I already have my choice. Even though the pot was crazy.
Yeah.
Let's do Lateralis, right? Let me see. Lateralis, I believe. This was great, too.
Yeah, it was, man.
Let me reserve my judgment. Because what I was trying to do, guys, is I was like, let me. Oh, Schism.
And then we got Schism, we got Enema, and we got Fear Inoculum.
I was going to jump out the window and say this might be the best tool song, but now that we're revisiting.
Yeah, I'm telling you. I can't choose, man. I really can't.
This was hard to me, though, dude.
I remember you really liked this.
I let it,
and as I listen to it again,
it gets better.
It gets better, man. It just...
Yeah,
it gets better. Because I wasn't in love with the song.
Yep, I remember
that. I was like, but it just gets better, man.
Yeah.
I think that we can end
this.
Yes.
I just want to wanted to do a trip down, take you a trip down memory lane, man, from what we've done through Tool. Because what I was, the reason why I went that route to kind of check out some of the older songs we've done reactions to. Make sure you guys, if you haven't, if you're new to the channel, check out those reactions.
Big time.
It's just that this really felt like really like a step ahead of everything else. But as I revisited those songs and really got They're all great.
But I think you can have personal favorites. But I think they're all great. I think you can't. I wouldn't be mad if somebody said, "Man, Schism is my shit."
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Oh, you know what? The Pot is my shit.
Lateralis,
you
know? And the Pot.
Yeah,
all of them are great.
I wouldn't be mad at
six
that.
And two.
Yep.
But this, to me, in terms of just the intricacy and the sheer skill that it seems that's required to pull this off and nail this. Seems special, but I'm gonna reserve judgment. Because
it does seem special.
Yeah, so I'm gonna reserve judgment.
And it seems like they kept what makes them special. They kept that those elements, right? But to me, it still invokes a certain newness to it as well.
Yes, it feels fresh. It feels fresh.
You know, so dude, it's incredible, man.
It feels fresh. Yeah, feels relevant. Timeless. Already, it feels timeless. I know that sounds ridiculous because we just heard it, but it has a sort of this is never gonna get old. Feel, man. This was great, man. Salute to the legends. Salute to Tool.
And salute to everybody that stayed on our asses to do this. I mean, all the people that requested this over and over and over again, I see why.
Sometimes see doing why. Tool, because we understand that Tool has some overzealous fans, so, you know, some of y'all kind of can be a little much. So sometimes we're like, let's breathe. Let's let Tool breathe to stay away from some of the fans for a while. But I'm really, really happy that we did this song.
Yeah, man.
This is
incredible.
Stayless. Excellent song. That's the interview, guys. If you enjoyed that video, please hit the like button. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. And also, guys, check out our Patreon channel if you're interested. It will allow you to get exclusive access to our content. The link for that will be in the description. I'm George. That's Ryan.
Las Vegas. We out. We out.